Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we are going to cover how to apply horizontal analysis. Horizontal analysis is evaluating data over a period of time, and it is called horizontal analysis because we compare financial information that is presented side by side. So, how do we actually do horizontal analysis? One way is by computing the dollar change from one period to the next. For example, let's look at a company that reports net sales of $100,000 in the prior year and $110,000 in the current year. To compute the dollar change, we take the analysis or current period amount, which in our example is $110,000, and subtract the base period amount, which in our example is the prior year amount of $100,000. And this gets us a dollar change of $10,000. This number is useful as we can now see that net sales increased $10,000 from the prior year to the current year. Another useful computation is percent change. To do this, we take the analysis or current period amount, which in our example is $110,000, and subtract the base period amount, which in our example is the prior year amount of $100,000. And divide that difference by the base period amount, which again is $100,000. This gives us a 0.10 or a 10% change. Using those formulas, we can compute dollar and percent change for all income statement line items. After doing this, we review amounts for anything that jumps out. We see a positive trend of gross profit increasing by 15.8%, which is the result of net sales increasing at a higher percentage than cost of goods sold. We also see an undesirable trend for selling expenses and for general and administrative expenses, with both increasing at a higher rate than the increase for net sales. We can also apply horizontal analysis to the balance sheet. We see an increase of $7,000 or 6.7% in total assets, but only a $2,000 or 2.4% increase in total liabilities. We also see that most of the growth in assets is from the sale of common stock for $1,000 and from the increase in retained earnings of $4,000. The $4,000 or 23.5% increase in retained earnings shows that of the $12,500 of net income, the company pays out $8,500 in dividends and reinvests the remaining $4,000 into the business. Property, plant, and equipment net, which we also refer to as plant assets, decreased by 5.5%, which is at least partly due to depreciation. Another part of horizontal analysis is trend analysis, which is used to compare data over multiple periods. Continuing our example, assume the company reported the following net sales data for the recent 5 years. To compute trend percentages for each of these years, we take the analysis period, which in this example is net sales from 3 years ago of $84,000, and divide that by the base period amount, which in our example is net sales from 4 years ago of $80,000, to get 1.05 or 105%. We can do the same computation for each of the next 3 years. Trend analysis is useful because it can help us quickly identify larger or smaller than expected changes, and then we can investigate these changes further.